On the web, we're used to working in two dimensions. Every element has width and height, and we move an element around the screen, either left or right, or top to bottom. Movement in the third dimension can be thought of as adding depth to our elements, and adding movement that comes towards or away from you. Think about a 3D movie where objects are constantly coming out of the screen towards you in an attempt to demonstrate the possibility of adding extra depth. In CSS, we can use 3D transforms. Before we get started though, you need to understand about axes. So on the 2D web, we move elements around horizontally and vertically. Each of these directions is called an axis. The horizontal line is known as the x-axis, and the vertical line is known as the y-axis. Now, in my illustration, these are angled so that we can see perspective, and this allows us to see our z-axis. This is the third dimension, and it actually is coming towards us. So here in this illustration, you can clearly see x is the horizontal, Y is the vertical, and Z is the depth. It's the dimension that would come towards you. When we move things around using 3D space, if we move something to the left, that can be thought of as using a negative movement on our X axis, and we would use a negative number to represent that. If we were to move something over to the right, then we're going to use a positive number, and this is indicating positive movement along the X axis. The same is true for the y-axis. When we want to move an element up, we're going to use a negative number. When we want to move an element down, we use positive numbers. The third dimension, our z-axis, is going to use positive values when the element is coming towards you and negative values when the element is going away from you. In order to create 3D movement, we're going to use the 3D transforms. And the transform property is actually the same one that we use for 2D transforms, so you're already familiar with that. The transform property accepts a range of functions as values, and each one is going to apply a different sort of transformation. You should already be familiar with many of these functions because they're quite similar, or in some cases the same, as the 3D functions. We still have rotate X, rotate Y, but now we add rotate Z. We also have scaling in X, scaling in Y, and now we're adding scaling in Z or scale 3D. In addition, we have translate X, translate Y, and now we're adding translate Z and translate in 3D. We also have perspective and matrix 3D. Matrix 3D is similar to the matrix that we looked at in our 2D transformation section of the course, but it's a little bit more complex. It actually takes 16 values. Because of its complexity, we're not going to be looking at that in this course, but we will be covering the other 3D transform functions. Now that you have a quick overview of what the transform functions are and how the axes work, we'll go ahead and we'll start to apply these to web elements.